Hi, I'm Rick. I'm at Bailey Bee Supply today, and I want to show you how to calibrate a refractometer. So I have one here. I'm going to go through unboxing it so you can see what we have in it. We open it up and we have the refractometer. We have calibration oil, a dropper that you can use for transferring your honey sample to the refractometer, and a small screwdriver to change the calibration setting of the refractometer. And the top, just remove that foam, and there are instructions on how to calibrate the refractometer and a wipe that you can clean the refractometer with after you clean the sample off. So let me set these aside. I'll explain a little on the refractometer. This is the prism where you'll be placing your sample. Here's a cover. You just flip this cover back. The sample will be placed directly on this area, and you'll see there's a gray line around here. You want your sample to completely fill this area and try not to have any going outside of that. But a very thin sample is what you need, just enough to where when you close the cover, it will completely fill that space. So first I want to calibrate it, so I'm going to put some calibration oil on it. So I'll set it down. I'll bring the lid back. I believe the instructions say a couple of drops. There's one there. One there, and then you can tilt, let it run sort of back and forth. Try to keep it within that gray line. As you see, that went very nicely. It filled the area in that gray area there. And then I like to take my finger and just apply some pressure and press out any air bubbles that might be in. That makes a very thin film, which is what you need. And then you want to hold this up to a strong light, like a sunlit window. And you'll look through and you can actually see the reading through the eyepiece. You can grab the eyepiece and twist it back and forth to focus it, so the numbers are in focus for you. And then you should see the top, you'll see a line, a division between blue at the top and white at the bottom. And that place right between those colors is your line that you want to read. And on this, you would just adjust it then to whatever the calibration fluid calls for. And I believe this one is 71 on the brick scale. You will actually see when you look in the eyepiece, there is a scale in the center that's bricks, that's BRIX percent, and another scale to the right that's a percent water. So this one is already adjusted to 71 on the brick scale, and it will read just a little more than 27% water. So if it's not calibrated properly, this is just a rubber cap that you take off, and then we have the small screwdriver, and there's a small adjusting screw, and while looking through the eyepiece, you would just turn this little screw back and forth until it's reading on the line that matches the value of your calibration fluid. After you have it calibrated, just place this little cap back over so it doesn't get tampered with or changed. All right, now I will show you this still has the calibration fluid on it. So I'm just going to open it up and clean this off before we do a sample. So I just take a damp paper towel, and I'm going to wipe this oil, and then I wiped it with damp, and then I'll go over it with dry to get that oil off. like most of that is off. And then you can take this cloth that comes with it, sort of polish off, pick up the rest of any fluid that may be on there. Okay, so now it's clean, we're ready for a sample. So I've got a honey sample here, and I'm going to use the little dropper to suck up my sample. It doesn't take an awful lot. Should be enough there. Open it up. Probably a couple of drops. And I believe this honey may have been too thick to do this. Okay. Okay, I'm not going to raise. Since the pipette did not work too well on getting the honey onto the refractometer, I'm going to try plan B, and that's just to take some honey up. Here, and just dab it. And it really doesn't take as much as you would think. This may be enough right there, and I'll see when I close it up. And you see it's starting to spread, and I take my finger and I press down, rub it back and forth with some pressure, working any bubbles out and getting it to completely fill. That's an underfilled sample. That will not give you a correct reading. It didn't spread up into here. So I'm going to need to add a little bit more. Better to add smaller amounts and work up than to go the other way around. You really can't press too hard. I've got some bubbles in there. I've got to work those out. Looks like that's not working, so I'm going to lift it back up again. Possibly need a little more in that center. It is important to get those bubbles out. I'm just pressing, making a really thin film. Still not there. It does create a suction. There. I think we've been successful now. Okay, that's completely covering. I don't see any bubbles there. So, we're ready to read the sample. So you hold it up if you point at a strong light source, you can go outside, and that probably works the best for you, but we can shine it right at this window and hold it up to your eye, just like you did with the calibration fluid, and you just, you may already be in focus from when you calibrated it, but focus the eyepiece here, and then you read your sample, and this one is less than 17%, so that's a good honey sample. So I'm just wiping that honey sample off. And when you read your sample, you want it to be, you want your honey sample to preferably be less than 18%. So honey needs to be between 18% and maybe as low as 15 or 15.5%. Now, see that you'll see some honey still on there. I need to get some more water on this paper towel and wipe one more time. Paper towel that's much more wet this time to dissolve this honey. And you can see I've got water actually beading up here. So I want to dissolve all this honey sample so it doesn't contaminate my next sample. And then a dry one. Mop it dry. And then the cloth that came in the kit. Polish it off, the cover and the sample area. So that one is ready for the next sample. Microbial growth cannot occur in a food sample or in honey if the moisture content is less than 18.7%. So that's why we're shooting to have honey that's like 18% or less. A lot of times you'll find honey that's probably around 16.5%, and that's very acceptable. You will not have any problem with growth. You just keep your honey at room temperature, and you'll be good to go. Enjoy.